Hey, this is Lisa, and today I'll show you everything you need to know about how to display numbers with Datawrapper. So, no matter how you upload your numbers to Datawrapper, you can actually always decide later on how you want to display them, how you want to format them. So, you could decide to only show a certain number of decimal places, or add a percentage sign, or a currency sign, or any metric sign, really. And here's how to do this. So in a line chart like this, you can change the number format of these vertical axis ticks here. You can change it in the Refine tab and then when you go to Number format. And these options are always the same. No matter if you want to change the number format in a tooltip or in a numeric column in a table, they always look like this. So let's go through them. The default option for most of your number formats will be something like this. This placeholder here shows us that our numbers will be displayed with a thousands separator. So that's great, but what's up with these square brackets here? Well, they show us that Datawrapper will display two decimal places, two digits after the decimal point, if they're relevant. To explain a little bit better what that means, we can choose another number format without the square brackets. So, for example, this one. You can see that our 0.1 still gets displayed nicely, but all of our other numbers suddenly have these trailing zeros, like the one decimal place, which is what our placeholder here shows, but not necessarily what we want. To get rid of them, we could choose this one and not show any decimal places at all. But then our 0.1 would be shown as a zero, which is also not what we want. So that's how we can use these square brackets. They enable us to show decimal places when they're important and to not show decimal places when they're not important. So now we know how to display small values nicely. But what about the really big ones, like these ones? They take up a lot of space. How can we make them take up less space? Well, there's a number format for that too. And it's here. There are these K number formats. If we choose them, a 1 million doesn't get displayed as a 1 with 6 zeros anymore, but as a 1 with an M. And a 1000 gets displayed as a 1 with a K. 1 billion gets displayed as a 1 with a B, etc. So that's way better. You can see these K number formats also come with decimal places. And to demonstrate that, let's add a really random number here. That's too big, that's better. 35 million, okay, that sounds good. But if we want to show also the decimal places, we can, for example, choose this number format, 123.45k. Now it shows us two extra digits behind the decimal point. If it shows just one digit, it rounds it up to 35.5 million. So that's also great. Let's get rid of that again. Okay. And let's go to our default number format again. These number formats display differently depending on the language you're in, and that's super important. For example, in Germany, where I'm from, this is not how we display numbers. We display them differently, and you can go to the Design tab and then to Output Locale to display the numbers in the format that your language prefers them in. So, for example, for Germany, you see, it looks like this now. We actually use periods like dots as thousand separators, and we use commas as decimal points. People in Switzerland do it differently too. They have spaces as thousand separators. Yeah, we have like a lot of different languages here for our output locale. For example, even Japanese. Let's see how this looks like. It seems like it doesn't really change anything. But if you then go back to the Refine tab and choose the K number format again, you can see how the words for million and billion and thousand, like K, M, B, are now translated into Japanese. So these are some of the number formats you can choose in this drop-down. We will link to an Academy article below that explains the other options. And there's also this custom option right here, which sounds very exciting. To show what that can do, we will switch to another chart. This one shows price changes in the last 20 years of consumer goods and services. So these are the products that became more expensive and these ones became more affordable. And we chose the number format 0% sign to show this percentage sign up here. That makes sense. But what if we want to show not just the minus values with a minus, but also the positive values with a plus in front of it? We won't find this in this dropdown, but we can do that with the custom number format. Here we can write our own number formats. So to show the plus sign, we would write a plus and then a zero. And yeah, now we get the plus signs, the plus minus zero and the minus 50 is still there. But the percentage sign is gone, so we can simply add it like so. We could also add like decimal places like so, and we can also add square brackets like so. They won't have an effect here, but it's the same idea that we just saw. But let's pretend for a minute that these are not percentages, but US dollars. How would we show a currency symbol here? Well, that's pretty simple. You just write a dollar sign and then your value. And again, you can add digits, but you don't need to. But don't see this dollar as a dollar. See it as a placeholder for the currency of the country you choose in the output locale. So if you choose, instead of US English, where you see the dollar sign, you choose Great Britain English, you will be confronted with a pound sign. The same with German, let's go there again. And there's your euro sign. If you choose Japanese, do that again, you will see a yen sign. Again, this currency symbol that you're putting here, that dollar, is just a placeholder. But if you're reporting from a Japanese newsroom about price changes in the US, you don't want a yen symbol here. You want a US dollar symbol there. To show the US dollar symbol or like any currency symbol or metric independent from your output local, let's just delete this one here and go back to our normal number format. And then let's go to step two, check and describe. There we can append and prepend metrics, currency symbols, anything to our columns. To do so, we can click on this table header, like B, and we should do this for the first actual number column. And that's enough, we don't need to do this for all these other number columns. And if you click on it, you will find the option to prepend and append right there. So we can simply add a dollar sign here, or we can add a US dollar sign like this. Don't forget the space. You can add the space or delete it as you want. You can do the same with any other like letters. Basically, you could write square meter like so, or something like this, miles per hour, kilometers per hour, as you want. So let's see if this works with the US dollar sign again. And let's go to visualize. And there it is. And on our first axis tick, the US dollar sign appears now. So yeah, this is how you can work with number formats in Datawrapper. You can do that anywhere, like really, the number format dropdown will appear with the known options we just looked at. For example, in tables, you can add percentages like so, or like with the square brackets, to make sure that it shows up as 66%, but as 72.7%. You can also use the number format in tooltips. If you click on this little arrow here, the number formats that we just discussed will come up, like so. And that's it. If you have any more questions, leave them in the comments.